What is going on, guys? Today we are going to be doing something a little different. I am here with Lady Mischief, my wife, and we are going to be trying snacks from the UK.
I heard that you've been talking some snacks.
A couple of these we have already gotten into, like this one here, because I've eaten the US version of those, and I just kind of wanted to compare, and I hadn't had any of those in years.
We'll eat them again, though.
And I was just like, you know, I want those. So I did eat a couple of those.
I just want to give thanks to Tennessee Princess for providing these. And if you guys want us to try more, we'll put our post office box.
P.O. Box is down below. And of course, if you have not already, subscribe to this channel. There's a whole bunch of random crap on here. The channel started out as... it started out as like some random live streams throughout the years. And I never really planned to do anything with it, but I always wanted to do a YouTube channel. Done Pokemon card openings for a while, a few random things in that process with Lady. You know, now I mostly do different survival games, horror games, and stuff like that. And occasionally even some Warzone. Like, this channel is a mixed bunch of nuts, literally. So we're gonna give these a shot and see what these are like. Make sure you check Lady Mischief out. Her link will be down below, as well as a link to our vlogging channel. Go subscribe to both of those. Like, do it. It's mandatory. If you don't, when spring and summer hits, you will have so many fire ants in your backyard. It's real. It is real. So what do you want to start with?
I don't know. Do you want to just...
I don't know.
Close your eyes and...
No.
Pula dilly, pula dilly.
No.
Just pick one. You want me to do
it? Is that one of everything? Do we have so far?
That's all that we've got.
No more nasty Marmite chips.
No. Unfortunately, we ate all the Marmite chips already. We tried them in the car because Ray was like, let's try some of these early. So then we opened those and I ate them all.
I did not like them. I do not approve of anyone.
Even our daughter did not like them.
Yeah. I don't approve of anyone anywhere in the world eating that. It's just gross.
Definitely a preferred, Acquired taste.
Is mayonnaise an instrument?
Acquired taste.
I mean, if you prefer...
Not preferred. I do not prefer that taste.
I mean, you can, you know, prefer them or not prefer them.
I think our dog prefers the taste of his butt over those chips. I've heard that Marmite is supposed to be like this nice topping to put on things and that it's a little sweet. It is not sweet on those chips. It is just like salty, bitter, and nasty. Somebody told me a lot it was supposed to be like a snack. Like a good treat.
Yeah, it's a snack. And Vegemite is a snack. And you put a little bit on toast.
What is Vegemite?
It's like Marmite, sort of. But it's different. I think Vegemite, one or the other is a little bit sweeter. Maybe Vegemite.
I thought Vegemite was like a thing you mixed in the soil.
No. No, it's a
maybe that's for Miculite, maybe? I don't know.
I know
what I thought Vegemite was. It's not Vegemite, but it's another word that they use it in incubators as a substrate under eggs whenever they... Anyway, that's completely off topic.
That's definitely not... We did not eat that.
You want to try the Monster Munch?
Yeah, let's do it. Pickled onions.
So, for those of you that... are here in the US and I've never heard of Walkers, but Walkers is the UK's branch of Lay's. So Lay's and Walkers are basically under the same umbrella. That's why the logo is so similar. If I can get this to focus in here, come on camera, focus. There we go. Yep, Walkers, Monster Munch, pickled onions. I'd imagine these are probably gonna taste a little bit like Funyuns.
They're pickled though. It might be a little sour. I have a little bit. I don't know. Why don't you open them bad boys and smell them?
Here, you go first.
You want to smell them?
Yeah, smell them.
Oh my goodness. That, honestly, smell it. It almost burned my nose. They're probably good. I mean, they smell like vinegar. They just burnt, like, hit my nose. Very
Monsters
abruptly.
Are here forever. This snack is best before... 11/20/2021. These just expired.
I told you.
They didn't expire. This is the Best Buy date. So.
And that is not on Tennessee Princess because she sent us these 2 months ago.
It says miniature monsters with big crispy heads or crunchy claws plucked straight from pickled onion beasts. Bite off each crispy toe, or is it an arm? Nibble the sides or stick.
Stick your tongue through what? Through the hole and let it melt in all its oniony, vinegary glory. Okay, well, cover your ears, children. Do not let your kids read this bag.
Yes. Even though it clearly looks marketed for children. Why don't you go ahead and eat that?
We're going to try it at the same time. Oh. You get you one. Oh, yeah. We're going to have... I think... I mean, it smells kind of like salt and vinegar.
We didn't bring a trash in here. Like,
You're just going to have to chew it and swallow it. You're going to have to put on your big boy britches.
This makes me want to throw up.
Maybe it just smells like vinegar. I mean, my pregnancy nose might be off.
It does smell like vinegar.
It don't smell bad.
All right, let's go.
All right, ready? One, two. They're not bad.
They're not good either.
Those actually are pretty good. They're almost like...
I taste the Funyun taste.
But they're like a sweet salt and vinegar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like...
They're like a sweet onion. Vinegar. And then the aftertaste is very like... gone. Once the flavor's gone, it's like...
Yeah, it just tastes like a, Like you just ate a Funyun, the aftertaste does. They're honestly... Want another one?
I'll get this little piece in there.
See if Milo likes them. Milo? You want a chip? He was reluctant.
Oh. That does not pass Milo quality control. Aww.
Did he not eat it?
No. He spit.
So, yeah. Our review of Monster Munch is, like, my opinion, it's not that great, but it's not that bad. Definitely don't smell it. All right, let's...
Okay, you want to just...
Yep, yeah, just sit those to the side. And let's go to another Walker's product. Let's try...
Oh, boy.
The Walker's, a.k.a. Lay's Tomato Ketchup Chips, which... Lay's does make a ketchup chip. They're mostly in Canada, but you can get them here. I've tried Lay's, or I've tried ketchup chips before, but not Lay's or Walker's. This says some see potatoes, we see potential. And it says, you can't see it and I don't want to focus it in, but it says 100% great British potatoes. So, I don't know what British potatoes taste like, but I'd imagine dirt is dirt, and they probably taste about the same as U.S. potatoes, so,
I think so.
I mean, you gotta think, Idaho is known for our potatoes, in the U.S.
Shout out to Idaho.
Yeah, shout out to Idaho. Potatoes. All right, suitable for vegetarians. Well, I would freaking hope
you
so.
Smell. I mean, I smelled the last one first.
They smell like ketchup. Straight up ketchup.
Kind of like the ketchup at McDonald's that's been like sitting out for a little
while. These actually don't look bad. The ones I tried were like red. Ready?
Yeah.
They're definitely better than the other ketchup chips that I've tried. But they honestly just kind of taste like ketchup.
Worse than ketchup.
No.
Because I like me some ketchup.
To me, it tastes like ketchup, but it's like extra vinegar in the ketchup.
Maybe if you like crunch these up in something that would...
I know what these would go great in.
What?
Meatloaf.
Yeah.
put it as a topping over meatloaf, crunch them down, and then put your ketchup or meatloaf or, sauce, whatever you want to put on top.
Or instead of breadcrumbs, maybe use those in the meatloaf.
Yeah, yeah.
But by themselves, I'm going to give it a thumbs down.
I could eat them. Moving on, I mean, I went back for more, you know, so they're not bad. I like them.
I think I'd prefer the Marmite chicken.
Heck to the no. I think I would rather starve to death and digest my own stomach than to eat Marmite chips.
Let's try these.
What are those?
These are Twiglets. I don't really know. They're probably kind of like a pretzel. What's it say?
So here's Twiglets, Jacob's Twiglets. Let's focus that in. For those of you that care to read these, go ahead.
Okay. Crunchy, savory whole wheat sticks. Totally original, entertain your senses. Only Twiglets give you the distinctive, knobbly shape combined with a zingy taste and crunchy bite for all-around sensual satisfaction.
Sensual.
Sensual.
I believe here in the States that that word oftentimes has a completely different definition.
Sensual. Good one.
I thought these were going to be pretzels.
It said zingy. It's like a
oven baked, not fried, high in fiber. This is going to make it poop.
You're not going to like these. Give that a whiff. Give that a smell.
It's Marmite.
It smells just like Marmite.
No, dear God, please, God, no.
But you gotta try it. Heck yes. These are gonna be mine.
All right. They stink.
They smell like Marmite.
Exactly, they stink.
Are you ready?
No.
All right, 1, 2, 3. Mm-mm. Very bitter.
Mm-mm.
They almost taste burnt.
I don't want any more of those ever in my life.
Okay, so if you had to eat another one of these, or you had to wear a Depends all day,
I'd be wearing that diaper proud.
Would you?
Yes, I'd be wearing that adult diaper all day long. Why? Yeah, here, just here. Let's show them what these look like.
Like, you can see the pieces of flavor on them.
How close can we focus? There we go.
There's y'all's sensual snack for the day. I'm not a huge fan of those either. They're not, they taste burnt.
You pick the next one. I picked two before that.
Let's try.
Don't ever pick those again, though.
As much as I'm kind of not really wanting to try them.
Me neither.
We got prawn cocktail chips.
Pato.
Mm-hmm. Pato brand.
Castle cooked. Not kettle cooked. Castle cooked. Since 1956. Set deep in Ulster's countryside is Tato Castle, where Tato have been making some of the world's best loved crisp and snacks since 1956. So if it's the world's best, how come they're not known everywhere in the world? Finally, in a secret part of the Tato Castle, our crisps are given their special flavor, ensuring you get irresistible crisps every time. Secret flavor room. And they spell flavor like flavor.
Give them a whiff. They smell like,
They smell like Chattanooga.
Unbathed Chattanooga?
Yeah.
They're not as bad as I thought they were going to be. But they all are vinegary.
They smell like somebody need to go take a bath.
They don't smell that bad.
That shrimp. No, you got a little chip. Let me.
Yeah,
there we go.
Let's
get a little chip.
Yeah, get a little sample.
You know what? I can't do that to y'all.
Oh, well. You want me to get a big chip, too?
I've got to go with a full size chip.
Well, it made me feel bad.
I mean, I gotta.
Well, that's a little full.
We gotta say we at least gave the review, you know, a chance. We can't be over here going, taking nibbles off stuff, you know? We got this.
All right, ready?
No. I know, likey.
They kind of taste like they smell.
Yeah, they kind of do, and I kind of don't like it.
Paired with a dip, it might be okay.
I mean,
let me have another one.
I don't know. With the more I let the flavor just kind of.
The more you chew.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It could also be one of those snacks, like the more you eat, the better they get. You know what I mean? So we have some chips that are just okay, but after you like get halfway through the bag, you're just like, man, those are delicious. I don't taste cocktail at all. What I do taste is, it's actually weird. It almost tastes like I just ate some shrimp. Amazingly, it's got no shrimp in it. I guess probably just they use saccharin as a sweetener. That's cool. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's just supposed to be like shrimp cocktail sauce flavored chips. Maybe not actually the shrimp itself.
The cocktail sauce.
Yeah. And they may have put something on it to try to flavor it kind of shrimpy, but I don't know. I'm not a fan.
So far, that one I also gets a thumbs down from me.
I can eat them. I'm not going to complain. Like, you know, that's the only thing I've got to eat. And I wanted a chip that bad. I would be okay eating those. But now we're going to bring up another Tato product. This is the one I looked at, and I don't know, I have high hopes for this one.
Yeah, I'm excited about this one.
Tato as well. Is Focus? No, there's a Focus. Tato, beef and onion. The secret's in the flavor. So yeah, they have a secret flavor room. Yep, basically says the same thing on the back. All right.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to these more than the other.
A little bit. Oh.
Wow. Well, let's hope they're good.
It looks like the UK has the same problems we do with their bag just ripping right down the side. They just stink. They freaking stink.
Let me smell. Or I'll just get a chip and smell.
No, here. You can have that bag.
Can smell the bag?
They stink.
I don't smell too bad. I smell the beef, like beef flavored, almost like beef flavored ramen packet is what it smells like.
Like they just soaked a bunch of potatoes in like beef broth.
That don't smell too bad. Not as bad as the other ones did. All right, here we go. Those are good. They kind of make you think of the Marmite chips, don't they? A little bit.
And with a hint of like Salisbury steak. Lady approves. I do not. I don't need another one to conclude my.
Oh, yes. I do approve of these.
My opinion of those.
Mmm.
Those taste like butt.
They taste good. They do not taste like butt.
Yeah, they do taste like
butt. He is insinuating that I like the taste of butt, and that is not.
If you like the taste of those, I think you like the taste of butt.
Those are very good.
Milo might like those. He likes the taste of his butt. Want to try one?
No.
You want to give it to the Milo test?
Well, you're going to make it look like I like to take the taste of butt. Milo likes a lot of things.
Milo!
Here, Bubba. You want one? Come here. Up here.
He's just like, no, I ain't laying down. That last treat y'all gave me tasted like butt.
Oh. He's not sure. Oh, no. He definitely approves of that.
He definitely approves. So, yes, they take that butt.
Milo, no. See, that's what I thought was going to happen.
These are hula hoops, but it's not onion rings like I thought. They're potato rings.
So I figured these was going to be like Funyuns, so now I'm all messed up because I just read the bag and found out that these are potato crisps rather than, or potato rings.
Hold on, what does the bag say right here? Oh.
Why not try barbecue beef? Ugh, what is wrong with y'all?
Barbecue beef?
Salt and vinegar and cheese and onion?
Cheese and onion. Well, it might be okay. We have,
Hula hoops are cooked with 100% sunflower oil and are completely free from all artificial flavors, colors, and MSG. Of course, they still taste as great as ever. As if putting all that other garbage made them taste better. I don't know. Snacks can be enjoyed as a part of a balanced diet and healthy lifestyle, including regular exercise. Actually, the most important part of all that is just exercise. So, yeah, these are not Funyuns, like I thought. These are potato rings.
I kind of feel like these are going to be very fine and very bland.
I think you're right.
World.
They're like round Pringles. Weird. They look like round Pringles. Like if you rolled a Pringle into a ring, a thick ring. She's thick, boy. Yeah. That's what you get. It's literally just a ring. Last I checked, potatoes did not make rings. They're not onions. You can't just get rings out of a potato.
Who needs bugles?
No. I'm imagining these taste a little bit like a stale Pringle. Wanna try?
Maybe. It might taste, yeah. Let's go.
Yeah. It's a stale Pringle.
No, they're not bad, though. Well. They've got a weird taste, but they're not terrible.
No. It tastes like a stale Pringle. They're just not as salty. It tastes healthier than Pringles. And, they're very greasy, though. Like, hold on. I don't know if you guys can see this, but I'm going to try to let you guys see this. I don't know if you can see the amount of grease on my fingers just from the couple that I ate there. I mean, I prefer those. I like them. Like I said, I think they taste a lot like Pringles or even Lay's, I think, makes a tube of chips. Tastes kind of like those, not as much salt, a little bit more bland, and because they're thicker, they taste almost stale because they're not thin and crispy. But they're good. So for the sweet, I think we're going to start with the one we've already opened, which I think is going to be my personal favorite. These are called Jammy Dodgers. And I don't know, for those kids that grew up in the 90s, you probably remember the old tins of like cookies that your grandma had that she had to beat your hands to get you off of them.
And then she
had this, they always saved the container. A lot of times it had like buttons and sewing needles and stuff like that in it. But my great grandmother always bought these. I have no clue where she bought them. They were just like this little cookie that had, like a cherry jam in the middle, but it was like super chewy. But they were so good, and that's exactly what these are. These are raspberry flavor, and let's go ahead and gonna try to show you guys the ripped packaging from where we ate that. These are double stacked instead of the single layer like we're used to here in the States, and ours are also not called Dodgers. And you can see it's a two-layer cookie. That's just some from the cookie beneath it. And this is not actually like super super gooey. Like it is gooey, but it's not like it's not gonna drip out. Like it's in there.
Cookie jam, yeah.
And it's actually less sticky than the ones that I had as a kid. So let's try these. I forgot. Brownie. They're not as chewy as the ones with kids from here in the States, but
they're good.
They taste pretty close to the same.
Can you get you some milk?
No. I approve of these. Jammy Dodgers from the UK. They're good.
do this one.
The Turkish Delight.
Yeah.
So these are made by Cadbury, which is a company we do have here, but we do not have fries Turkish Delights. Let's try to focus this in here. Yeah, fries Turkish Delights, and as you can see, they are made by Cadbury. If you guys want to read that, milk chocolate. Turkish Delight wrapped in delicious milk chocolate.
What is a Turkish
Delight? With a Turkish Delight.
It feels sweet.
Turkish Delight, 76% covered with milk chocolate. Even the ingredients don't tell you. And it's best before 11/19 of 2021, so we're going to eat it when it's not best. For those of you that know what a Turkish Delight is, let me know, because we're about to eat one wrapped in delicious milk chocolate. Oh my...
What the crap?
I don't know. Here, you eat the bigger side. I don't know if I'm even going to like this.
It's like a jelly.
It's like a jelly in there. Oh, God. Hold on. So, like, some of the chocolate, like, flaked off, but it's like a gummy jelly...
fruity.
...thing in there.
You smell it.
Oh.
Like a fruit. Fruity.
Oh, God. I'm going to hate this. It smells like my mother's old herb shop. Yep.
All right, ready? Oh, I dropped chocolate
on your floor. Yeah, this tastes and smells like my mother's old herb shop. I've tasted that before in that herb shop.
You have Turkish Delights in our herb shop?
No, but there was something in there. I remember. It tasted like this.
So I kind of like the density of it. Really chewy and thick.
It's not even a gummy. Like, it's in between a gummy and...
like...
it's in between a gummy and jelly.
Mm-hmm.
So it's starch and sugar that's mixed to make a gel. It is typically flavored with something, and in this case, I don't know what this something is. If anybody knows what the actual gel in here is flavored like, let me know down in the comments, because I would really, really like to know. I've tasted that before. I don't know what it is. Let's try the Cadbury Dairy Milk.
I'm going to get me a little bit of milk.
Okay. You want to go ahead and pour me some milch? Cadbury is a brand that we have here in the States, but they don't make chocolate bars. They make, like, the Cadbury eggs that I absolutely hate. They make those stupid hollow bunny rabbits around Easter that I absolutely hate, and the little Santa Clauses around...
I do not form a mob.
Christmas that I absolutely hate.
Those are very popular in the U.S.
They are, but they taste awful. Like, the chocolate literally tastes like just some little, like, startup company decided to make chocolate. I don't know how long Cadbury's been around. I know they've been around for a long time.
Yeah.
But Hershey's chocolate is 100 times better. $4.95 for a chocolate bar. That's
impressive.
That's a lot of money for a chocolate bar.
I mean, it looks like... I mean, look at the wrapping on it. It's very...
I mean, I get that. I feel like...
Yeah,
I feel like I'm going to open this up and find a golden ticket and go to Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory. Here we go. This tastes like standard Cadbury overly sweet chocolate. Yep. Yep.
Yeah, it's not, it's kind
of... I don't like
it. It was okay. To me, there's been weird flavors lately. Maybe because they're expired or past their best by date. But it tastes different than our chocolate. It's not as good as our chocolate to me.
It's too sweet. It tastes like it's got too much sugar in it. Of course, I like a dark chocolate anyway. I like a less sweet, dark chocolate. I like to taste the actual cocoa
and
flavor.
See, I like milk chocolate. So the sweet wasn't chocolate too. A problem for me. It just had a weird...
I just don't like that milk chocolate. Go ahead and pick the next one.
I have tried these before. I have not tried this brand.
So yeah, Jaffa Cakes, Jacob's. These have an orange on them, so they kind of tell you what to expect a little bit, whereas the ones we ate before did not. So it says 10 spongy cakes covered in dark chocolate with that squishy, no, not squishy, sorry, squidgy.
Squidgy?
Squidgy.
Oh.
Not orangey, but orangey. Orangey. It's
supposed to be orangey.
Centre. I know it's centre, but anywho, I will never get tired of making fun of the UK's English. And these look different than the ones we've had before. Yep.
Well, the ones that we had before kind of melted on the way here.
I mean, true.
So
they weren't they individually wrapped or something?
There was like, it was like this is what happened to the other ones.
All right.
A little bit.
So this.
Ooh, smell.
This is a Jaffa cake.
They smell like orange.
Ready? I like it, but I don't like it. Sorry, that was stout. It's like an olive, you know? You eat an olive, green olive, and you're just like, oh, this is bad. And then like you chew it, and you're just like, you swallow it, I want another one. And then you just eat the next one, and you're just like, oh, this is bad. But then you just keep eating them, and you kind of like them, but you don't like them. That's where I'm at.
I know last time I had them, they were very good paired with coffee, if you like coffee. And I think they would be better with a big glass of milk, maybe even dipped in the milk, because the cookie part is dry.
I'll tell you why. The cookie will fall apart and you'll be stuck with a slimy whatever that is on top. I'm serious, that just happened.
That
to me.
Is the squidgy.
That's squidgy. Centre. No, squidgy orangey centre.
Orange flavor.
The orange flavor gel to me just tastes like, you can tell it's an orange flavored gel, but it literally tastes like an orange flavored gel. Like it tastes very artificial to me.
Almost like an orange gummy, sort of.
Yeah. I'm gonna try these. So these are the UK's version of the Whopper called Maltesers. So they're malted milk balls. I don't know who puts these out. This packaging looks very generic, so for all I know, this may be like the worst brand of malted milk balls there. Okay, so they're made by Mars Wrigley. So the same brand that makes Mars bars, which we don't have here in the States anymore. They have those over there though. And Wrigley also makes gum over here. We do have the gum, juicy fruit. And stuff like that.
Yeah, we do have that.
However, this is the UK branch, and they are made in Ireland, Dublin, Ireland. So, yeah. So I guess we could say these are Irish malted milk balls.
Okay.
Let's go.
Tastes like a Whopper.
Tastes like a Whopper.
The sweetness of this, the chocolate of that, tastes way better than the Cadbury.
Yeah,
way
I agree.
Better. Like, I'm not a big Whopper fan, but I do want another one because
and the malt in the middle, really good. I like it.
Yeah, these are actually decent.
And they're not as crunchy as ours. They're a little more airy, so hate to say this, but I think I like Maltesers better than I do Whoppers.
Yeah, me too. Same.
So this is Cadbury Crunchy Spread, manufactured in Belgium. So it's not even really a UK snack. It's more of a Europe snack. But either way, from what I understand, it's pretty popular in the UK. If it's not, let us know. But this is it. So it kind of reminds me, just from what I see, it's milk chocolate spread with honeycomb pieces. So,
oh, honeycomb.
Yeah. So it's kind of like nothing we have here. Can you smell that?
Smell that.
Ooh, that does smell good.
That smells heavenly. Yeah, we got two. You're good.
All right, well, I'm going to stir this up since there's like a ton of like loose honey or
if y'all could smell that
something on the top. So this looks utterly disgusting. Let's focus in here. This is what this cracker looks like. Yes.
That's very good.
Nutella, move over and eat your own heart out.
Kyrie is going to love that.
She ain't touching it. This is mine. Very thick.
Mm-hmm. But it's really good.
The last candy we have. We got a couple more things. Well, not the last candy, but we do have a couple more things. The last chocolate candy we have is Nestle Arrow. So Nestle is a company that we are all familiar here in the States. Several years back, Hershey came up with this Hershey Arrow chocolate, which is the Hershey bar, a little bit smaller than normal, and it had like little bubbles all in it.
Everybody freaked out.
Everybody freaked out over it. I think they made some M&Ms that were like that too. Yeah.
I don't know.
Just so you guys know, M&Ms is made by Mars. So we do have Mars chocolate here. We just don't have a lot of Mars chocolate bars and stuff like that. This is basically Nestle's version of the Hershey's Aero bar. This thing has
melted
completely
apart. Oh dear.
Completely crumbled apart. It's a war zone in there. It's a disaster.
It's a war zone.
Hakuna Matata.
I like it.
I don't like the chocolate.
I do like it.
We don't. Too sweet. I didn't like it. I'm sorry.
Chocolate bar.
I'm sorry, UK. I know I've looked at a lot of your stuff and I've been like, I don't like this. And I apologize, but there are a few things that y'all have that we don't have that I do like, you know? So there's that. All right, so this next thing is Cadbury drinking chocolate. I don't know. Says to mix it into hot milk. We're not going to do that. We are simply going to drink it like chocolate milk. If that's a mortal sin over there in the UK, I'm sorry. There may be some people in the UK right now looking at this, going, watching us mix it into cold milk, going, no, that's not how you drink it. But, you know.
Possibly.
Regardless, that's how we're going to drink it. How much of this are we supposed to mix?
I
can't read whatever this is.
I think it said 2 tablespoons on the front or somewhere. I don't know where I've seen 2 tablespoons at.
No, I don't either.
Ovaltine is where I've seen 2 tablespoons.
Well, that's got nothing to do with this.
No, I know. So I don't know. Dude, I got confused.
So there's like this foil thing on the top. Care for your fingers.
ASMR. Now you can slow it down for ASMR. There you go. There you go. With your tea? Yeah.
All right, let's go. Let's try it.
Some little granules. Something.
What, you want to stir it up?
No.
There's no granules.
Poofing it out. There was little granules of something. Quit poofing it.
I don't know how much is supposed to go in here, but.
Well, considering you said you're not gonna like it, I wouldn't put a whole lot. Put like that 1 tablespoon in mine.
Okay. If you care to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This.
Oh.
All right. Here we go. Mixy, mixy.
This is why you're supposed to eat out.
A hydrophobic powder. It doesn't get wet. Well, oh, the temperature's just going to make it magically not hydrophobic?
It's almost like those protein or like slim fast
It's like mixing protein powder into your milk or your water. And you gotta get that little mixer ball and just like shake it till the cows come home. Moo 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 moo. Just give me that milk, moo 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 moo. Hakuna Matata. It tastes like Cadbury chocolate.
It's not bad. It would be better. It tastes like hot chocolate.
I imagine this tastes like Max Mofo's video where he made like that weird chocolate drink. Remember the, yeah.
The bunny rabbit.
The chocolate torture video.
Yeah.
Yeah, where the Easter bunny just like beat the crap out of him with all kinds of chocolate, made him drink this big, huge chocolate drink with like Cadbury eggs. That's what this tastes like, I feel like. I mean, it's good. It's just not that good. That makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, it's okay. I mean, yeah. I like Ovaltine better.
Here we have Stockley's since 1918. Rhubarb and custard. Let me focus this in because that way you guys can see it. Pay no attention to the expiration date. I'm sure it's far, far gone. No, it's not.
Oh, really?
No, they're good until February.
Oh,
yeah. Let's give these a shot. They don't smell bad. They just smell...
They smell like sugary.
They smell
candy.
Like sugar.
Yeah.
Rhubarb and custard. Gluten free.
Mm-hmm.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. Sweet hard candy.
Yeah. Taste some rhubarb more now.
Mm-hmm.
I think of everything I've tried so far, I like these the best.
Really?
I love those.
It's okay. They're okay. They're not my favorite thing, though. And I'm going to be honest. My review on these UK snacks, they're not very good.
You don't like any of them?
I like them okay. Like, this stuff is pretty good. Very sweet. But if you have a sweet tooth, it's pretty good. I kind of like the beef and onion chips. I know you didn't like them, but I kind of like those.
I don't like much of the UK's savory stuff. I hate that, and I'm sorry.
They don't have as much flavor as
I don't like a lot of you guys' chocolate stuff. Like, to me, your chocolate's, like, super sweet, and I don't like it. These are amazing. I would imagine I would probably enjoy a lot of like fruity snacks and stuff over there.
The Maltesers were good, but they weren't originally in the UK. They were, where did you say?
Dublin, Ireland.
Oh, Ireland, yeah.
Cadbury is a product of Belgium.
Maltesers were good. Jaffa Cakes are okay. Jammy Dodgers are good.
So, do you have anything to add?
No, overall review of it is not very good. Most of them are not very good.
I like these.
Some of them were okay, but America's snacks are better.
For the most part. Of course, we've not tried all the UK snacks.
From what we have experienced so far.
Some of those weren't the UK snacks.
That's true. Turkish Delight was...
I didn't like it, but I liked it, but I didn't like it, but I liked it, but I didn't like it. If you guys know what those Turkish Delights, like what that gel in that particular Turkish Delight is, let me know. Not because I enjoyed it, but because nostalgia reasons. I want to know what that is flavored like, and it's bothering me and will probably bother me until I find out. If you guys have enjoyed this video.
Sorry, it's late. Mama Bear is tired.
But if you guys enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up. If you dislike, hit the thumbs down. Both of those let YouTube's algorithm know who may or may not like my videos. So it lets them know who to recommend my videos to and who to not. And as always, go check out her channel and, you know, drop her a sub and check out some of her videos. She does different kind of videos as well. We both stream on Twitch Monday, Wednesday, and Friday night. So come hang out with us there. We have a Discord. The link's down below.
And we also have a P.O. Box. If you guys want to send us some snacks, obviously sealed or we will not eat them, because there's some weird people in this world.
And store-bought.
Yes.
Not homemade.
No homemade snacks.
No bringing us homemade.
Go check out her channel. Drop her a sub. Give her some likes on her videos. We have Instagrams, Twitter, all that fun stuff. If it's a social media platform, we're probably on it. So look us up if you are interested in that sort of thing. And until next time, I will catch you guys later. Bye.
Doodles.